Now that we have MSODBC and Anaconda installed, and we can run Jupyter Labs, let's go ahead and install pyodbc, and that'll let us talk to MSODBC through Python. Now, one other thing we're going to do is, if you notice that up here in the corner of my Jupyter Lab notebook, it says I'm running Python 3, and there's a little radio button, but it doesn't actually do anything. This is showing me the version of the Python kernel that I'm running in this notebook. And this works perfectly fine, but it doesn't actually support debugging, which is a relatively recent feature in Jupyter Labs, Jupyter Notebooks, and doesn't come out of the box with Anaconda, at least as of when I'm making this video. So if you already have debugging stuff shown here, you probably don't need to upgrade your Anaconda installation. But if you don't, then you're going to want to do that as well. And so I'm going to show you how to do both things. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get out of Jupyter Labs because we're going to want to restart it after we update our software. So I'm going to go to the File menu under Jupyter Labs. And then at the bottom, you should see something for Shutdown. And that will shut down Jupyter Labs. And I'm going to confirm Shutdown. So it tells me that it stopped the server. And now I can close the tab. And so I'm going to go ahead and I'll close the tab. And I'll minimize the window. And we're going to do everything for this next bit from the command line. So I'm going to go ahead and close the Anaconda Navigator as well. And yes, I'm going to quit. And then I'm back at the Windows desktop. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the Start menu. And I'm going to go to my new Anaconda 3 folder where I've installed Anaconda. And you'll see that one of the options here is Anaconda Prompt. And on Windows, this is going to give me a command shell. On Linux or Mac, you'll probably get a bash window or a terminal. But one thing that's really important about this next step is I want to install to some directories that you need admin privileges to install to. So I'm not just going to click on Anaconda Prompt. I'm going to right-click. And under More, Run as Administrator. And if you're on Mac or Linux, you're going to want to use sudo or sudo to get superuser access to run these next commands. I'll say yes. And then here's my command shell. So let's start by installing pyodbc. And we're going to use conda, which is the Anaconda package manager, just like pip is the Python package installer. Conda is the package installer for Anaconda. So I'm going to go conda install pyodbc. And conda has extensive knowledge about compatibility between and among various packages. And so it will try to avoid a situation where you have incompatible packages installed into your environment and your code won't work as a result. Okay, so apparently I have pyodbc installed already. Let's go ahead and do the update. If you hadn't seen this, what it would have said is it would have shown you some stuff that was going to get installed, and then it would have asked you if you wanted to continue, yes or no. And you type Y for yes if you want to install the updates, and N for no if you want to skip and not install anything. So should be straightforward other than that. And then next thing I'm going to do is conda update --all. And that's going to update all of the packages in my Anaconda installation. But in order to update some of them, it's going to need to actually downgrade others to avoid incompatibilities. So it'll tell us which ones will get updated and which ones will get downgraded in just a minute. Okay, so shows me the updated packages and the downgraded packages. And in particular, for the debugger to work, I need to see it upgrading ipykernel and ipython. And those are the things that are necessary for debugging. And then you can also look at the stuff that's getting downgraded and make sure that nothing you're using really is going to have a problem here, but you shouldn't have a problem. So I'm going to go ahead and say yes to proceed. And it will do a bunch of installation. Okay, so it updated everything. So let's go ahead and start Jupyter Labs and see if everything looks good. But I want to start that from the folder where I have my notebook. So I'm going to cd, let's go to users, and then I have a mark account on this machine, and my notebooks should be in here. Yeah, so cd notebooks. And then I'm just going to run Jupyter Labs from here. So Jupyter Lab. And that should pop up a browser window. Okay, and it went ahead and popped open my browser window in Edge. Okay, so here's my workspace. Here's my test DB program from before. I'm going to go ahead and make another new IPython or Python 3 notebook. And then I prepared some example code for you. So in the core shell, under the Python installation video in Unit 1, under installing pyodbc, where this video is located, there should be a code example. So I'm going to go ahead and copy the code in the box. And then go to my Jupyter Lab, and in that cell, go ahead and paste. And then if I run this, after a minute, it should go ahead and show me a graph. So what this code is doing is it's using pyodbc to make a connection to cisdbss.pcc.edu. And then it's connecting to the names database on that database server. It's executing the SQL command, which fetches the name count for the name Mark and with a C and Mark with a K for male babies on a year-by-year basis. Then it's doing something called a pivot, which we'll learn about later. It's reshaping the data so that I have two columns for the two names. And then it's calling the plot method to create this graph. Now, also, you'll notice that before I just had the circle here, Python 3 ipykernel, but now I have a little bug icon with a switch next to it. So let's go ahead and see what happens when I turn this switch on. It goes ahead and opens debugging panes, and then also up here with my code, I should be able to actually click on one of these lines and put a breakpoint. So I'm going to go ahead and click right there, and I get a little breakpoint next to line 22. And then while the debugger is on, if I run this code, oh, actually, I wanted to be in here and then run the code. So Alt or Control plus Enter to run the code. And you'll notice that it's actually stopped here at this breakpoint, and I have access to the variables. So let's look at the variables. In particular, I have df, which is a data frame, and I can open that. And look inside of it. So I have a gender series and a name series and a name count, which matches the columns that I fetched. There should be a year here, and so on. So a bunch of properties of a data frame. So that all seems to be working okay. And then under this call stack, it's showing me where I am in the code. And also I have these buttons here. I can continue execution. I can step over this line of code. I can step into the line if it's a function call, and that will show me inside of the code. I can step through it there. But I'm just going to go ahead and hit run for now. And I get my plot. So everything seems to be working correctly, and I'm ready to use Python in this course.